Hello everyone, my name is Aditya Lele and I will be the executive board for the All India Political Parties Meet. But for now, I am here to explain you the rules of procedures for the WASE Model United Nations. What is rules of procedures? Basically, these are the rules of the competition, the rules of the debate, and how a delegate is expected to debate and on what points he is going to be marked. Because at the end of the competition, we have some awards for the delegates in each committee. So I will be explaining you in further videos what are the rules of procedures. But before we proceed to what are the rules of procedures, I would like to tell you why do we actually follow rules of procedures, or for that matter, why the United Nations follows any rules of procedures at all. We have to understand that United Nations is a supranational body or an international organization consisting of many countries. For right now, it's more than 190 countries and some observer status organizations. So there are different kinds of ways and different ways to greet and meet people. Some ways in some cultures might be respectful, but the same way can be disrespectful in some other culture. For example, if you see the language and the tone of the North Korean people, and if you watch some of the North Korean news channels, it is a very aggressive tone, it's a very loud tone. But just some 1,000-2,000 miles apart, to the east of North Korea, there's a nation called Japan. And in Japan, even speaking loudly is found to be very disrespectful. Japanese people are normally very silent, very cool, very calm in their gestures, and any loud tone is said to be very disrespectful in their cultures. Therefore, there should be a uniformity in how all the nations and delegates of all the nations conduct a meeting, and there is no disrespect to any of the delegates. So all the nations have come together and decided that okay, these will be the sets of rules where we will discuss and deliberate a topic which will not be disrespectful to any culture of the world, and therefore rules of procedures. Secondly, the rules of procedures are for the peaceful conducting of sessions and the productive sessions of United Nations. What I mean by productive sessions is that the debate should not be disrupted at any point of time because there is no discipline in the house. Unfortunately, but normally we see many disruptions in the Lok Sabha or the Rajya Sabha or the state legislatures for that matter. This is because many MPs or MLAs do not maintain a decorum, do not follow the rules of the house. But in United Nations, there are different sets and different stakes involved for all the delegates and diplomats. So one, for a peaceful and productive debate for every session, has to follow a rules of procedures. Now, if one more point to be added in this session is that everyone or every nation is equal in United Nations. What I mean by that is every nation has an equal chance to speak in every committee to which it is a member of. So if it's not like other economic institutions like IMF or World Bank, where the stakes of the nations decide how much power a nation carries. It's not like that in United Nations. Every nation has an equal respect. And to maintain that kind of equality in United Nations, we need rules of procedures. And that's why rules of procedures are very important. Thank you.